What I think most people in this city, whether it's business owners or educational establishments or just parents, do not understand is that digital businesses and tech businesses from Hull affect people's lives daily, both locally, nationally and globally. And there are so many incredible digital businesses in Hull that most of us have never even heard of, because you just go from day to day doing this great business. Digital has come to us, and it's the opportunities that we get from the recent changes in technology, the recent developments.
Because the possibilities of a career in these digital industries are endless, and the amount of jobs and sectors that it's now prevailing, it's exponential, the growth. So digital is taking over every career or every industry, and having those skills and being digitally savvy and being able to apply them is the key thing. And then this place is designed to show students opportunities in a sector, in a range of sectors and a range of industries that are currently employing people around digital and engineering.
So APD Communications are a local company based in Hull, always have been founded in 1984. We provide software to the blue light market, but mainly the police. We have three products, Artemis, Aspire and Cortex. Cortex is an IX, an integrated communications control software, which is in police control rooms and helps them deal with organise their assets. Artemis is a telematics piece of software that shows things like driver behaviour and more commercial fleet management.
We provide phone and broadband here in Hull, particularly our fibre offerings, but also we have a national presence, and more we're working with enterprise, large enterprise customers like HMRC. We basically manage the graphics for about a third of the world's big shop. We manage those graphics from the point of view of what you see on shelf, but also what you see online. We're based all over the UK. Our head office is here in Hull, and we're very proud of being here in Hull. We've got quite a big presence here, but we've also got offices nationally, London, Exeter, Wakefield, Ipswich. The C4DI, which is a brilliant organisation, has given a focal point for all of these businesses to stand up and be counted. And Hull has got a significant digital industry. It's one of the top tech cities outside of London.
And so we opened a trial co-working space in 2013, thinking it would be gym membership for techies, thinking that all the financial reasons why gyms work would work, a whole bunch of people would come down, you'd make just about enough money, and good things would happen. And quite quickly realised there was much more to it than that. What we had was building a group of people, all of whom were looking for problems to solve, all of whom were skilled in digital skills, and they were keen and looking for opportunities for work and opportunities to solve technical problems. So that was one group of people.
We help big companies, large companies, create innovative solutions to problems that they have. So they come to us quite often and say, we've got this problem, problem A, and we think there's a solution digitally. Can you help us find a solution? So we spend quite a bit of time with them, understanding better the problem, and then we basically start to plan out a project, and we build what we would call an MVP, a minimum viable product, so the client can then start to understand what we're looking to build for them to help them get around this problem they're having.
The second group of people was traditional industry locally, the likes of ABP, Reckitt Benckiser, Smith & Nephew, saying, you've got a building full of problem solvers, could they solve problems for us? And at that point we thought, there's something really quite exciting and interesting that can happen here. We can bring together a tool, a kind of a cohort, if you like, of interesting techies, developers, designers, all of whom can solve problems, and we can bring those together with traditional industry to help that industry innovate and grow. Startups and scale-ups will have access to supply chains and mentors they wouldn't normally have access to, and the traditional organisations would have access to skills that they wouldn't normally come across. And that's essentially at the heart of what C4DI does in helping tech companies grow and traditional businesses innovate.
We want young people in Hull and East Riding to be aspirational and aim for a raft of careers and to have no kind of ceiling to what they do. What we're also really keen to do is to raise the bar of the quality of employee in every job and every industry. And there isn't a job that you can do now that doesn't have digital skills required to do it successfully. There isn't a job that doesn't have employability skills, communication, innovation, entrepreneurship.
The thing about digital is that it's the coming together. So it's seeing lots of things and in your head putting them, oh, if I did that and that, that becomes a new opportunity.
It's really, really hard to find females in the digital economy. Some software firms have got ladies. So KCOM do have a team led by Lindsay that have got software developers, but they're few and far between. But actually what they tell me is it makes a big difference. One of the companies source said, you know, it makes a difference if you've got women in the team. And I think that's true wherever you are in industry. If you've got a mixed team, you get a better output and better business outcomes.
So what is that that lights a fire under them? What do they enjoy doing? It tends to be something that would run through their life. So if they are a software engineer, they will go home. As soon as they get home from work, they'll probably code something else in, you know, in their spare time. They'll be looking up new and exciting languages and other types of technologies that could fit in with work. So it's something that goes right across their interests and their life and ultimately what they're passionate about. We find that if you can create that and you've got people that are passionate, that they will not view coming to work as a job, and they will get out of bed in the morning and bounce to work.
We're looking for people who can come in, look at problems and go, if we use this bit of technology here and use that piece of technology there and that piece of technology there, we can provide a client a much better solution rather than trying to shoehorn, say, a Microsoft technology into the solution. It's all about looking at the bigger picture and what can you bring in to this project?
Well, I would say probably out of 750, I wouldn't be surprised if 600 are from Hull. And what's wonderful about the place is that just about you can pick up Skype and talk to just about any of our offices in the world, and more likely than not, you'll get a Hull accent answering you.
How do we get into it? I don't think there is any one path into it. I think you've got to be willing to learn, willing to keep learning, and just look and grab the opportunities and talk to people about what they're doing and what role that you can play and get them to advise you.
So the first thing is dress appropriately for your interview. Personally, I always think you should be very smart. For example, for software developers, they don't tend to be particularly smart people. They can work in jeans and a t-shirt. That's what they come in to work for. I would still suggest to people that they wear a shirt and trousers to look smart and appropriate. One of the big bugbears that I personally have, because it's one of the very first questions we ask, is have they done their research on the company? So to me, a job should be a two-way street. Not only should we want the person to work for us, but they should really want to work for APD as well. It shouldn't just be a job. So to do that, research. And there's obviously varying levels of that. The very minimum I would expect from someone would be looking at the website. Tell us a little bit about the company, what we do, what markets we're in, the name of our products.
I started making websites when I was younger. I started when I was about 10. And that passion just continued to grow. I wanted to do that for a living because I enjoyed it.
I was always set that I wanted to work within games. I wasn't sure if it was going to be like analog games, like board games and stuff, or if it was going to be video games. I just liked game design.
It's getting that mindset where you know what you need to achieve, and it's finding not only the best technical way to do it, but also how it's going to be fun. Because the hardest thing about games, you can have the best idea and have the greatest team, and you put a demo together, but it might be boring. And there's no one telling you, oh, we need to, you know, if you change this, the fun will increase.
They should just immediately start thinking about design and not like, and look at all kinds of games, because not just video games, like just and kind of look at the games more analytically, like what makes things fun or what is it about the experience that is enticing to them or that they're enjoying.
I always tell them to contact these software firms. They're quite a few are pretty small firms in the area, but C4DI has got a lot of small firms there, and I'm sure they would show you around. And I think just understanding what the wealth of opportunities are. So you don't have to just be a software developer. You can be marketing, you can be finance within that industry. So I think some people think it's just people who code, but there are lots of different opportunities. So people who understand what a business needs versus what the coder's going to put forward, you need someone who can do that translation, and ladies will be brilliant at that. They will be brilliant at programming, but there's lots of opportunities. But not many of them are known about because they're pretty new.
15 is way too early to make a decision on life. So make a decision for now, but understand it's not dictating your life. You can change and grow as you go forward. So look at the opportunities and take them, but take them knowing that other opportunities will come.